thank you so much. I'm here at the very vibrant PepsiCo office, thanks to Vani. Vani,
thank
of you. Course, is the marketing director, food and Indian snacks here. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, Vani, first things first, tell me, how's the journey been so far as a woman, as a leader, you know, in this corporate scenario?
Well, it's it is a tough journey. Mm-hmm. It's I think for any woman, it takes a lot of what should I say, personal organization, a lot of you know, an ecosystem that one has to have built around oneself in order to be able to give the best to both work as well as home. And I think there is no running away from the fact that as a woman, you are expected to and you want to give the best both at home as well as at work. So while work is of course expected as a professional, but as women we take on the responsibility equally to do whatever we have to do to make sure that everything at home is in perfect order, is provided for, the, you know, the fridge is stocked, everything runs on time, things are working, homework's done, birthday gifts organized. All of that takes organization, it takes pre-planning, and like I said, I think there is absolutely no substitute to building an ecosystem that helps you, you know, run your daily life.
I think that's also to do with probably like how we were discussing earlier in the cafeteria that, you know, women are probably emotional quotient is much higher.
Yes.
I don't know. I don't want to make a sweeping generic statement, but I somehow feel that women are caregivers and nurturers.
Yes.
So they want to take on that responsibility of ensuring that everything goes smoothly, whether at, you know, at home or at work. But in your personal experience, and as a leader, have you seen a disparity as compared to men versus women that have been or you've been associated with, you know, in your various avatars and various journeys through the corporate world? In this being able to fulfill all duties, whether at work and at home?
So, again, I might sound maybe a little superficial and I might sound a little too generic, but I do think that men, by and large, tend to focus more on their job and don't worry as much as women do. Woman, it's also in many ways expected of her. It's a very, very deep social conditioning that is very difficult to break out of.
And you think some of that can be addressed if you have supportive partners?
Because absolutely.
The number of women that I have interviewed and who have reached a certain level, either, and there are no in-betweens really, either they have support or conducive environments at home, or they've given up, you know, completely on their journeys.
Yeah.
The third thing, of course, is that they've, you know, probably split from their partners and they're on their own pursuing their goals.
You couldn't have said it better. I completely agree with you. I think it is very, very critical for a woman to do well at work, and for her to be able to go up the corporate ladder is for her to have chosen a partner well. You know, a partner well chosen who can truly share the load.
And not just corporate, I think even on an entrepreneurial
level. Oh, absolutely. Oh, absolutely. You know, for there is no way a woman can excel at work if she has to give 100% to the house, where she's required to take care of all aspects of the house and make sure that there is dinner on the table when he comes back home and his shirts are ironed and everything is in order in the morning and tiffins are packed. There is no way that you can do all of that by yourself and still do well at work.
Right. So, and there is nothing like, one would imagine that, you know, things happen at a certain social structure or certain economic level. It's people like you and I who are part of this very, very ingrained, deep-rooted mindset that are actually bearing the brunt of this.
You're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. I mean, even today, I have a very close friend of mine, and she comes from a very well-to-do family, and, you know, there are I am educated. And she was under a lot of pressure to have a male child.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow.
So, you know what, when
this we're talking about upwardly mobile, well-educated people.
Absolutely. I'm talking about my friends. And one wouldn't think that this is an issue that one would have to deal with in societies like ours. The reality
and
is...
And we're in 2018.
Exactly. And we're in 2018. And we are, you know, supposed to be the liberated lot.
Right.
You know. So, I don't think this issue is irrelevant. Everything that we talk of in the world of everything that a woman has to sort of break out of for a working woman is very, very relevant today. It's there is a lot of very basic stuff that women are still dealing with today.
Indra, I know you had made a comment which got very publicized considering the position that she holds and the comment that she made. I feel somewhere it's the environments, unless they're conducive, then you say, okay, you know, I don't care. Okay, I can't have it all.
Yeah.
That's where it comes from. It's not because she's saying that women can't have it all.
Yeah. Women are always riddled with guilt. It's just a feeling that you have to get comfortable with. You know, you're always guilty about not doing enough. And even when you have everything, even if you were to have supportive, supportive systems around you, and you were to have a very supportive partner, and you know, the organization were to offer you flexi timings and all of that, even then women take on a lot of pressure in terms of going the extra mile. So I don't think there is, women can ever have it all. It's always tough.
Maybe we shall overcome one day. Hum honge kamyaab. Okay, if you were to give one, maybe three steps to a successful career, as a leader and as a woman, what would that be?
I think first would certainly be that there
stop
is
stop being
no,
so hard on yourself.
Yeah, stop being so hard on yourself. Exactly. You know, it's okay to leave the house dirty, and it's okay. The key is to be able to prioritize and to say that on the home front, there are these two or three things that I take care of which are non-negotiable. And the rest, it's okay. It doesn't have to be perfect. The second I would say is to certainly build an ecosystem around you. Because for me, being
I keep hearing this all the time.
No alternative to that. You have to have supportive neighbors. You have to have supportive domestic help. You have to have people you can reach out to in terms of in times of emergency.
And there's no harm asking for help, right?
Oh, absolutely. So you have to get comfortable asking for help. You have to be able
to reach out. Why is this such a kind of, for me as well, I struggle with this for asking for help, because I want to be like, I can do it on my own.
No, you don't have to do it. Exactly. There are a lot of women who feel guilty about this, and you say, oh, but I'm a single mom, or I'm a working mom, and I may have to leave my child at,
exactly.
Is it okay if I were to leave my child at your place for a couple of hours? I'm really sorry, but I'm unexpectedly delayed. I had expected to get home, but could you please take care of him? It's okay to ask. You know, now I've sort of learned to swallow my ego just go out and ask for help.
Wow.
You know? And I think the third would be to just make time for oneself. I don't think we do enough of that. You know, as women, we always feel we're obliged to give time to either the work or to home, which means, attending to domestic affairs and children. But we don't calendarize me time. And I think
how does Vani Gupta categorize or calendarize the me time?
Yeah, so for me, me time is, if I do get lucky and if I'm able to make time, then I do some painting.
Wow.
Yeah.
How nice.
Yes.
And I think as a last parting note, I'd like to compliment you for being the person that you are, the woman that you are, the mother that you are, and the corporate leader that you are. And also the fact that if you have to be there for your son, to read that story to him night, it's not because you're pressurized or you're self-inflicting something. It's because
I want
probably
to do it.
You wanted, your emotional quotient is much higher, and that's how how everybody should be.
I feel it's the least that I can do, because I'm not there the entire day. So for me, that little time in the evening that I get with him, when we have, you know, a little time before dinner and then the bedtime story, it's the only routine that we try and keep sacrosanct. You know, that's the only time that I really try. Nothing interferes in that time when I'm with my son.
Thank you, Vani.
Thank you.
God bless you.
Thank you.
It's been a pleasure.
Thank you.